so I can't really do nail tipping now. But anyway, I might drop them down in that box from this package. We'll see. But anyway, right now I'm gonna unpack it and just take a piece of gum. It's like more than 12 million registered citizen, so that's too many. And all the major airports are situated in Moscow, so you should expect it to be the most infected city. So, while in other regions of Russia, the situation, well, seems to be becoming better, here it's only getting worse. Although the quarantine measures were set up maybe a couple of weeks ago, I'm mixing up all those dates because I've been sitting at home for a month already. Nearly a month, a few days, shorter than a month. And still, no positive progress. I saw statistics yesterday, and it said like there were about 1,300 new patients admitted into hospitals with coronavirus in Moscow. That's huge, and everybody suspects that it's the result of the previous week, or no, the weekend before the last one, when everybody expecting paid holidays came out into the streets to party, walk, and mostly party with some kebab frying. It's like a popular activity in warm days of spring and summer. And yeah, nobody says it's okay to do when there's quarantine. That was so stupid. But so nowadays we all suggest that all those large numbers of newly admitted patients must have got infected during that weekend. And some people keep nagging, saying things like, well, how did the kebab go? But I don't think that's right to say it's, well, what good will it do if you say things like this? Yes, it was very stupid to do so, but what can you do now? What's the point of nagging? I don't know. But because the situation is getting worse in Moscow, in my city they're gonna draw up some new quarantine measures, make it stricter. So before, well, right now, we're still allowed to go outside to the nearest shops and drugstores and to see a doctor or to walk a dog or any other pet. But they say that from the upcoming Monday, they're gonna draw up some strictest measures. It's gonna stand like this. Nobody will be allowed to leave home without a specific permission that you've got to like acquire using the internet on like a state website. You've got to ask permission basically even to go out for shopping, for food. They say it's gonna be like this. Honestly, I don't see any point in this, except for maybe it would be easier to catch those mad folks who are indeed infected with coronavirus and they still go outside because, I don't know, maybe they just don't believe that it's really a disease, or they don't think that they can infect other people by just sneezing or coughing, which is absolute rubbish, of course. And you see some videos where, like, for example, a man who is suspected of being infected, maybe he came back from another country or something, but he's suspected to be infected, and he's running away from the police who are trying to catch him because he might be infected. And, like, man, you go out into the streets and you subject all the people around you who may be just going out for shopping, like to buy something, or they walk a kid, or they walk a dog, and you subject all of them to danger of being infected from you just because you don't obey the measures. It's so stupid. Yes, of course. But for all the other people, just imagine what it's gonna be like. So, when I heard that they're not gonna let anybody go outside anymore, I went for a walk. I'm not being stupid. Honestly, I went into the forest where there's only like two people for a kilometer of road. Literally, nobody really goes outside anymore. People are in the streets. There are just quite few of them. And they obviously go for some shops or something like this. And nobody's in the forest, really. I was alone on the road almost all the way. I didn't contact with anybody, didn't come in close contact. I never come into close contact with people anymore. Except for my family, obviously. Well, we live together. How am I supposed to evade them? But I'm just saying that I went for a walk to a forest. I didn't contact anybody on the way. I was riding my penny board, and well, I just needed some stretch, you know, just a bit of fresh air. And that's about the adequate measures of quarantine. Now, about the inadequate measures. So when I went outside for the first time in a few weeks, I saw some, I don't know how to call them, they are not exactly police, they are like, I don't know how to call them in terms, but, well, they usually oppress some meetings, illegal meetings, but that's just basically people protesting. But in my country, they have to get a permission to protest for some reason. And guess how frequently they do get the permission. So usually those army men oppress meetings. So they're not police, but they are kind of like police, but they still are a bit different department. So those military men, I saw them in the street, and I live in an on the outskirts of Moscow, so it's just like they call it a sleeping area, like where there are only blocks of flats, a few schools, a clinic, and McDonald's. That's it. There's literally nothing more here, and shops, obviously. What's the point of setting police in this place? Nobody goes for a public walk here at all, especially nowadays. But still, I saw them. Then I saw, when I went into the forest, and I was already riding back home, I literally went only 1 kilometer in and 1 kilometer out. Quite a short distance for, frankly, for, well, I'm used to it, and for me it's quite short distance. I can walk that distance in about 15 minutes on foot, so really it's not a big deal. And I didn't meet anybody on the way except police riding horses. Yeah, we have horse riding police. They usually patrol this to another road because no, I don't want to meet you. I'm not breaking the quarantine. I'm not contacting anybody. And I still have the right to go outside if I don't contact anybody. And I don't want to contact police because they might be infected because they work with people. Unlike me. I'm just saying it's all very, very inadequate. So yeah, basically they're gonna set up all these new measures and I don't know what I'm gonna do. Basically I'll have to sit on my balcony, stretching with dumbbells, except for walking, instead of walking. Yeah, pretty crap. So yeah, that was my talking. And yeah, you can comment on me being irresponsible about quarantine, but I think you're wrong. The quarantine is about not contacting people, and I'm not contacting them at all. Really, I evade all the people, and other people evade me as well. So, it's pointless to say I'm not breaking quarantine. I'm going outside for fresh air, not for meetings with people. So yeah. Okay. So this glass has been waiting long enough. I got it out of its package especially, and yeah, it you can see it, how the lights play through the glass. Looks nice, I think. So let's do a bit of tapping. Try it out. Smash a like. watching this video and listening to it, as always. Write down in the comments which genre you prefer. Solid triggers or chill videos where I do any sort of rubbish that comes into my mind. Yeah, at this, thank you again, and I really hope to see you in my next video tomorrow.